We grabbed the attention of the White House.
Omaha began facing problems of gangs in the late 80s. That's when Bishop Robert Tyler started working with John Foster and Eddie Staton. They were all determined to be a force behind change, so they created Mad Dads, and their group caught the attention of President George H.W. Bush and his Thousand Points of Light program.
He spoke about the magnificent and wonderful thing that has happened here in Omaha because you have a beginning of a volunteer army by these mad dads that have just had enough.
And Mad Dads has taken off to places all across the country, but one of the founding fathers is still here in Omaha.
That man is Bishop Robert Tyler.
President Bush's program went to the local grounds, and he said these are the people who seldom get recognition.
This program is one of the thousands rewarded for volunteerism, and the president's recognition paved the way for other programs in Omaha, like U-Turn.
It crossed race, it crossed a lot of different things for him to come and to recognize a group of men in the inner city in the late 80s, early 90s. Mad Dads paved the way.
Pastor James Hunter says there's still work to be done to stand up to violence in the community, but George H.W. Bush leaves a lasting impact through Point of Light Awards. Reporting in Omaha,
we grieve in his passing.
Alex McLoon.
Like everyone else, but he made a significant, he will always be in our minds and our hearts.
3 News Now.
Tomorrow, the former president will be honored with a state funeral at the National Cathedral in Washington, D.C. On Thursday, a second service will be held in his beloved Texas.